Hi, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Christmas Room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Hey there, hi there, ho there. We're as happy as can be. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Christmas Room. Welcome to the Friday edition of the Christmas Room. All right, so we've gone through our videos for this week. A lot of them were on this camera right here, the Canon 90D. Fun. And I got a couple of more to do. I want to talk to you about the Tamron lens and maybe show you how I set up the Canon 90D from the beginning. So those might be coming up, and then we're going to switch to some other stuff. But since it's Friday, we've had news this week on the Canon R5. The overheating saga keeps floating to the top like hot air rises. I find that funny. I don't know. You know, it's not funny what's going on with the camera, but the joke. The hot air rises. Okay, so anyway, Roger, you I consider a friend of mine, but a distant friend. We've talked on the phone a few times. Very kind, gentle, nice, but super amazingly smart person. So smart, when he talks, my eyes glaze over, it goes right over the top. See how much room I have up top here? That's where all of... So, he is a genius. No, I take that back. He's with you, a super genius. He can shave a layer off of a sheet of glass so thin that you can't even find what he shaved off. But he can make a scratch on the sensor disappear. So the man is technically sound. He's like super amazingly smart and retired, kind of like me. I didn't realize, I just saw some pictures of him and he still looks much better than I do. Okay, so what he did is he took the R5 and he took it apart. Boom, opened it up, screws out, covers off, and now we have somebody that I can relate with as to how he thinks, how smart he is, and I became like really interested to see what he thinks. So the bottom line after everything, I would explain some of the stuff, okay, but the real bottom line is after seeing what I saw, there is no fix. There is no fix to the camera. You would have to change some major parts, do some re-engineering. You'd have to put some type of an air exchange system in it, and I don't believe it's going to happen. So what they're doing is they're tuning in the management of the heat that's there, okay? So that means if you're looking for a high-end camera, even though it's $3,900, a $4,000 camera, if you're looking for it to replace one of the high-end cinema cameras, it can be like a B-roll or a fill-in, but most of the people that I'm talking to right here, you guys aren't making major motion pictures, okay, for the industry of any kind. Maybe for yourself, maybe commercials, okay, or you're just taking pictures. So what this means is the camera is what it is, in my opinion, okay? However, I'm not the last word on this, obviously. Canon is. They know what's going on inside of their camera bodies better than we do. They don't want to share it. And I don't see a reason for them to share it, to be honest with you. So, he took the camera apart and took pictures. So some of the interesting things that I saw is there's a much bigger metal plate in there that can be used for heat management than I expected. I thought like Canon didn't even care. It's just like, this is the way the heat is going to happen, and it's going to happen. But there's a very large metal plate, and it looks like it's designed to draw heat out of wherever it's covering, which would be the circuitry and stuff. The processor and the CFX card, the CF Express card, is the two major sources of heat. Of course, other things contribute to the heat. And this metal covers it. And then there's a second one in another part of the camera, and it's not as big, but they're thicker than he expected them to be. I wouldn't even know what to expect, okay? But he said if it was a shield, it would not be as thick as it is. So it's probably meant to even out some heat. So another thing that Roger said that I caught that was interesting, his mind is very analytical. So he was thinking like the engineers would be the group that work at Canon that would be the least happy about what's going on because they weren't given a free hand to manage the heat. He said there's very little airspace and room inside the camera. So the question becomes, and he's right spot on, honest to goodness, where can the heat go? So he started looking for leaks in the camera and found the camera is very well sealed. Okay, so if you're into like weather sealing, okay, you found a very highly weather sealed camera. And that's good news, except if you're looking for ways for the heat to get out. So he was taking pictures and he started taking temperature readings. And then eventually he decided to take thermal imaging type pictures, the kind that I like to see, cartoons. You got colors, the brighter the colors, the hotter the spots. Okay, so now we're cooking with gas. Now I can understand some stuff. So he took pictures and it shows the hot spots and it shows even, now the pictures that he took of the thermal heating, okay, was not on an open camera, which you and I would not have an open camera. We would have a sealed closed camera that we would get from the camera store, wherever you would buy your camera. So it's not like you can open it up. So he took pictures of a completely sealed closed camera. So it's exactly what you would have in your hands. And that makes a difference because now I can associate if I were to buy that camera, what would happen? So the back of the camera, which, oh gosh, I don't have an R5, but the back of the camera, kind of like where the LCD is, a little bit over to the right, close to where the card would come in, is your major hotspot. And your other major hotspot is right next to it, which is the CF Express card. So they're right there next to each other. But that's not the only parts in that camera that makes hotspots, okay? There's other spots, but those are the glowing ones. And then he took pictures all the way around of a completely closed sealed camera, just the way like we would buy it, okay? And it showed like the screws on the bottom were shining brightly, which means those little tiny screws that you can't even find when you look at the bottom of a camera are seeping out heat. And then around like the ring, right around where the lens mounts, bright neon yellow. Woo! That the heat is coming like it's trying to come out. Probably the metal mount of the lens is dissipating heat without us even realizing it. So this is why I came to the conclusion, what's Canon going to do? I mean, this is what they have to work with. So they're going to raise and lower temperature shutoffs and cool downs. Okay. But the material that the camera is made of itself doesn't dissipate heat all that quickly, which is a negative. Then it's covered with that nice rubbery material that you feel when you hold it. And you go, wow, what a nice camera. So that's kind of insulating the heat inside the camera. So I'm thinking, what can Canon actually do other than an engineering redesign? And I don't see them doing an engineering redesign, to be honest with you. It would be like recreating the camera from scratch and make like heat channels and heat exchanges. And that ain't going to happen. So now comes the question, who is this camera for? Understanding that. Is it for the independent filmmaker that wants to put together his pride and joy or wants to do that type of work? Well, if you're going to work and record outside the camera onto, let's say, a Ninja or an external recorder, I have a Ninja, so that's why I'm naming it the Ninja 5 or one of the others, the heat doesn't build up that badly. The camera doesn't overheat and you can actually technically go on and on and on and on. So you add a Ninja, you've got a solution. Okay. Now let's lower it down to an ordinary type person. As my friend Simon, ordinary filmmaker channel. Okay. That's the ordinary filmmaker, not anything more than you and me. So that type of person that's going to make his YouTube videos, his family videos, the videos of his children, his son at baseball, his daughter at basketball or dance or whatever it is these guys and gals are into, and you want a high-end camera that does very good, that camera probably will work for you very well. Don't be planning on shooting 8K And I don't even think I need to say that, because where would you show it? And don't give me this cropping crap, okay? I want to crop in. I want to see the hair on my son's, mustache as it's growing in. That's full of baloney. I've never seen pictures where you have to, or movies where you have to crop in that much. So 4K itself, you can crop in like crazy and still come out with great imaging. So for an ordinary user, the everyday user, this is the high-end camera. If you've got the bucks and you want something high-end, I would say that camera's for you, which is basically the bigger market, because it's not the independent filmmakers and the little YouTubers that are high-end that's going to get into this camera that highly. And if you do, and you want to get into it that highly, guess who has an answer waiting for you? Sony! Yes, I'm having a hard time choosing between a Sony A7S Mark III and the Canon R5. And the reason that it's hard to choose is you've got the overheating on the one hand, but you've got 45 megapixels. On the other hand, you've got a better focus system. And yes, I'm going to say it. I know it's blasphemy, and I know it's not what you want to hear, but I watched Casey, my friend Casey at Camera Conspiracies. I watched him dealing with that A7S Mark III, and the focusing was spot on. It was hard for him to shake it. But when he took the Canon R5 and got into like a shady area, just walking on the street, into a darker area off the side where the trees were covering and everything, and you know what? The R5 had a hard time finding him. Isn't it supposed to go down to like -4, -5 focusing ability? Well, what happened? So I was very disappointed when I saw that. So it's like 1 week I lean over towards the Canon side, okay? And then another week I completely start leaning over to the Sony side. So you go like, well, why don't you just buy both of them? Get real. You guys got that kind of cash? All right. Do you? Are you going to be able to go out and just buy both of them? Well, neither do I. All right, I'm retired. I got a nice little Christmas room here. I can go out in the back, and I can go swimming, and I can come back inside, and that's about it. So it's going to be one or the other. It's not going to be both, okay? So that's who the camera is for. The upper-end filmmaker is going to be disappointed. Probably should be looking over at the Sony. But that's only my opinion. What do I know? All right, Peter Gregg, I have pretty much told you that the Canon R5 is a high-end picture-taking machine. Yep, very high-end. And yet for the videos, it does very well there too. If you're a videographer and you know how to grab onto that camera and deal with it, go for it, okay? But it is a harder camera to deal with than it would be in terms of the overheating and stuff like that, than let's say the Sony A7S Mark III. So I know, I've left you in a lurch. I haven't told you what to do, okay? So I don't know what else to say but to lay it out. I've gotten actually a few consultations this week on what camera should I choose, and we actually have to walk it through, okay? And then they have come through to the conclusion and have made their purchases. So now I'm waiting to see if they're going to be happy with their purchases. And that's it. All right, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, please subscribe. I'm asking for your subscription. And those of you that have subscribed, thank you so much. I love my subscribers. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida, catch you later. Have a safe weekend. I'll see you tonight. Those that are going to meet me with my live show tonight at 10 p.m., I'll see you tonight. Shh, don't tell anybody. Bye-bye. Whoosh.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.